they're kind of unique type of product. So now here customs examiners give us two headings. So remember, GRI 3 is two or more, right? So here we really face a question. If we analyze the heading, we will see that 9506 provides for articles of sports, for the sporting equipment, and 9542 provides for articles of leather. So again, here we are presented with this tangent that I mentioned earlier, and you will always see it throughout your classification journey, that you have this use provision where you have sporting equipment versus the make provision where you have articles of leather. So how do you resolve that? Which question really predominates? In the case of this one, we do not need to go as far as GRI 3. And the reason we don't need to go is because this, well, first of all, let's take a look, 9506. Let's take a look and see what 9506 says. So 9506, let's open up the harmonized tariff schedule, go to chapter 95. And we see that it provides for articles and equipment for general physical exercise, gymnastics, athletics, other sports, outdoor games, baseball is an outdoor game, not specified or included elsewhere in this chapter, and parts of those articles. So is it an equipment for other sports or outdoor games such as baseball? So is the baseball glove an equipment? And if yes, if no, no. Is it possible for the baseball glove to be an equipment? I think it's possible. It's kind of like special thing, right? It's specialty made item. It's you find, bless you, you go to the sports store, you go to athletic supply store to buy that product. It's marketed only for that purpose. It's not marketed as like some kind of fashion item. It's a specialty item. Because it's a specialty item and it is used to make sure you have the strongest grip possible on a baseball glove, on this baseball bat, I don't see the reason it cannot be classified as an equipment. But customs examiners give us two numbers, right? So one number was the HTSUS 9506, the sports equipment, and the other one was 4203. So going to this 42 chapter, let's see what we have. So we see already it's articles of leather, and we know that those gloves are made out of leather. So the next step would be to go to 4203 and really look at the text. And the text states, articles of apparel and clothing accessories of leather. So again, this is make provision. You have articles of leather. 9506 is use provision, exercise equipment, irrespective of what it is. So you have this tension. Is it possible that this is GRI 3? Well, to answer this question definitively, you really have to exhaust all your GRI 1 possibilities, General Rule of Interpretation 1. And those possibilities include the heading notes that we looked at. Those include the section notes and the chapter notes. So let's look at the chapter notes. So chapter 42, let's go way to the beginning of the chapter, and we have notes here. And chapter note 4 for chapter 42 has the following statement. and try to enlarge it. So it's visible. Let's take a look. For purposes of heading 4203, which is one of the suggested headings, the expression articles of apparel and clothing accessories, which it does say in 4203, applies to gloves, including those for sport or for protection. Well, that takes care of it right there. So they say that if it says 4203, then whatever is included in 4203 includes those that are for sports or protection. So what does it mean? Yes, we had the potential for the GRI3 situation because potentially by looking at the terms of the heading, they were classified as exercise equipment, as sports equipment, and they were potentially classified in articles of leather. But the note 4 of chapter 42 says, well, okay, since you have articles and of apparel clothing and sector accessories which apply to those that are used for sports or for protection, that kind of sets a foot down so you do not need to go outside of GRI1, or you stay within GRI1 domain, and the chapter note 4 settles the question. So going back to the example, you can kind of see that the correct answer was there. So 4203 is the dominant heading. But nonetheless, it was a good example of tension that you always have to check. GRI 1 versus GRI 3. Now, if we pass this hurdle, our first question, if you have potential classification here and here, the next step we have to do is check chapter notes section notes, if there are any. Sometimes there are no section notes. So I believe chapter 95. Let me see. Yes, see, chapter 95 does not have section notes. They're just missing. You have the section, but it's blank. So in this case, you do not go to section notes because they don't simply exist. Checks, but generally speaking, section notes is also legally binding provision. And only then you go to what? You go to the GRI3 and you start with A. Remember, there were GRI3 has three components. A, B, and C. And as with with anything, you start from the one, and you go down to another, and you go down to another. So this is a general methodology that you always use. The customs has to use it. You have to use it. And if you start to jump hoops, it may work sometimes. It may even work very often, depending on the questions that you practice. But if you do the shortcuts and you start immediately applying GRI3, and you try to start determining what's, for example, more important on your own, you may, for example, really, in the case of gloves, very well decide that, hey, this is exercise equipment. And I think exercise equipment is a better description. So you choose the wrong answer, right? So the point is taking shortcuts is dangerous. So first thing, establish if it's classifiable by looking at the terms of the heading. Make sure you can venture outside of GRI 1 by checking chapter notes, by checking section notes, and then you have a green light to start and your analysis according to the GRI 3 subdivisions. So what do? We start with subdivision A. So how do we analyze subdivision A? A good starting point would be to read the subdivision in the first place. So let's see what it says. The heading which provides the most specific description shall be preferred to heading providing a more general description. Let's stop right there. So, more specific description versus more general description. This is also known as the rule, GRI 3A has a rule of relative specificity. More specific rules. How do you decide? What's the measuring yardstick? How do you figure out is it more specific or is it more general? Sometimes it's hard to tell. Look at the baseball gloves, right? Is exercise equipment more specific or articles of leather more specific? It's hard to tell, right? And how do you know that you even need to do that? Well, in here I must make my negative comment about the way it is written. Because really, I think the second sentence, should come before this sentence indicating that there is a rule of relative specificity. More specific item predominates over less specifically described item. So, even before you get there, first thing you need to do is to look at the exception. Let's take a look at the exception. When two or more headings refer to a part only of the materials of substances contained in a mix of composite goods, or to part of only of items in a set of put up for retail sale, those headings are to be regarded equally specific in relation to those goods, even if one of them gives more complete or precise description of the good. So it's just a bunch of phrases, very important ones too. So how do we analyze this, right? So let's try to break it down to important elements. So first of all, the one requirement is equally specific requirement. So we have no right to even decide is this item more specific to the articles of steel or articles of plastic. So if we have a ladder which is made out of 95% steel, 5% plastic, because ladders are in articles of plastics and ladders are in articles of steel, each of them refers to a part of that product within an article. Therefore, we have no right to even consider under GRI 3A whether the item is more of steel, more essentially made out of steel, not of plastic, because it has 95% of steel. No, we are not even allowed to make this determination, not under GRI 3A. We may be able to do that later, for example, under the essential character analysis, if we may, but not under rule of relative specificity. So, what does it also mean? When are we allowed to make such comparison? Well, when we have reference to only a part of material or substance contained in a mixed or composite good. What does it mean? It's very well. Part of a material or substance contained in a mixed or composite good. That means that if we make the analysis under this clause, part of that material in a mixed or composite good, we can only make this analysis if we classify the product or analyze the classification for the product as the make, not use provision.